You have no right. You are banned from bitterness, from resentment. Not even against your husband. Let me show you the implication of bitterness. Now, if I take a piece of rope this a piece of fabric. If I use this fabric to tie my hand, if I turn this hand like this, are these fingers free? Can they do anything? Can I use these fingers to do anything? No, the fingers are not free. Why are they not free? They are tied. What about this fabric that tied the finger? Is it free? It's not free. Can I use this one to do another thing? Why is there? No. Can it tie another thing? No. Now, if I want this, if this cloth that is tying this finger, I want to be free. I say, I want to be free. What must he do? Is the hand free now? The cloth won't come. That's how it is with you. When you are angry, you are bitter against someone, you bind the person. And because you have bound that person is not free in God's sight. It's in bondage to you. But you too are not free because you have bound the person to yourself. And the most serious thing is about it is that if the person against whom you are bitter is an unbeliever, and every unbeliever is in the pocket of Satan, and because you have bound yourself to an unbeliever, and the unbeliever is in the pocket of Satan, where also are you? You're in the pocket of Satan. Anything the devil wants, he can do to you anytime. You have no freedom, you have no liberty, you have no strength. He can just do any damn thing to you. Because you have bounded yourself to him. So once you are bitter against someone, because you have bound yourself and bound that person, the blessing that you can't receive, the blessing that meant for you, you can't collect. You are not free to collect mercy. You are not free to collect favor. You are not free to collect any good thing. You are bitter. One of the things that can make you very bitter, particularly my sisters, is that you are praying to have children, and here is your husband. Instead of sleeping with you, he's sleeping outside, sleeping around. And then you can become very angry. It's not annoying. Very annoying. But the Bible does not allow you to be bitter, even in that, against him. What the demand of God is to love him. See, there was a time we had a meeting in Aja, and after the ministration, we were supposed to minister baptism, and there was this lady we were going to pray for. When we lay hand and the demon took over, it was very terrible. The church was using pew. She used her head to dismantle, scatter the pews, not chairs like this. It was moving four legs like a bull. It was not her, it was the demon. Now we stopped. What happened? She says she's bitter against her husband. What happened? What went wrong? See, the husband decided to abandon her and is following another woman. And he doesn't even do it secretly. He does it so openly. So she's bitter. And because of that bitterness, a demon entered into her and possessed her and was going to destroy her. So we asked to ask her to forgive her husband right there and then. And it was when she forgave her husband that we prayed for her, and the demon left.